Stefan Mladenovic, als eerst even over het meest vervelende van de avond. Dat is waarschijnlijk de blessure van DeJuan Wright. Wat weet je daar nu meer van?
Volgens mij is het iets met zijn Achilles, maar dat weten we nog niet zeker. En dat moet nog even afgewacht worden met de MRI-scan. Want we kunnen nu wel speculeren wat het is, maar voordat de scan gemaakt is, weet je het nooit zeker. Dus we moeten even afwachten.
Coach Kalin zat er in ieder geval helemaal door. En die ziet zijn kampioensaspiraties, ambities al going down the drain, om maar even zo te zeggen.
Nou, ik denk niet dat het zover is, maar het is, ja, DeJuan is gewoon een heel belangrijk speler voor ons team. En die hebben we gewoon zeker nodig. Dus het is heel jammer en spijtig dat hij geblesseerd is geraakt. Maar we moeten door als team en gewoon verder gaan.
Nou, wat positievere dingen. Je hebt zelf natuurlijk ook blessure gehad, dus je weet er een beetje van. Hoe is het met je?
Ja, gaat wel goed nu. Ik ben even kijken. In januari ben ik eigenlijk volop begonnen met trainen. En na 2-3 weken begon ik last te krijgen van mijn hamstring. En dat was eigenlijk een natuurlijk gevolg, zeiden ze, van een blessure, van een ACL-blessure.
Wat is dat voor de kijkers die dan niet weten wat je had?
Ik had de voorste kruisband blessure. Dus ik ben 9 maanden eruit geweest. En ik ben in januari eigenlijk volop beginnen met trainen. En na een paar weken had ik mijn hamstring geblesseerd. Dus toen moest ik weer bijna een maandje rusten. Maar goed, laatst gaat het goed en ik probeer gewoon zo fit mogelijk te zijn. Dat is het belangrijkste voor mij en het team zoveel mogelijk te helpen.
Maar gaat het goed? Op hoeveel procent zit je van je capaciteiten?
Ja, dat kan ik moeilijk zeggen. Ik denk dat ik wel qua fitheid wel zo goed als 100% ben. Maar goed, ik mis gewoon het ritme, want ik heb een jaar niet gespeeld. En daarom is het goed dat ik gewoon een minuut maak. En hopelijk kan ik de stijgende lijn voorzetten. En meer minuten krijgen.
Hoe is het dan voor jou om weer terug te spelen gewoon in Groningen? Heerlijk, hometown.
Ja, het is heerlijk. Ik woon nu weer in Groningen. Ik heb 5 jaar ergens anders gewoond. En het bevalt me hier. Het is mijn huis, hè. En het is heerlijk om voor zoveel publiek te spelen.
Je hebt bijna 3000, hè?
Ja, en dat maak je nergens mee in Nederland. Toen ik bijvoorbeeld in Rotterdam of zelfs Den Helder en Nijmegen speelde, speel je voor veel minder man. En als je dan hier komt, dan denk ik van wow, dus, ik was niet meer gewend en dat is wel heel leuk natuurlijk.
Dus je bent een tevreden man in Groningen?
Ik ben zeker tevreden en hopelijk blijven we de stijgende lijn voortzetten en kunnen we mooie dingen laten zien.
Mark Sanchez, of course we're not happy with the injury of Wright. Do you know anything more?
We don't know the severity of it. We're just going to take all precautions and see what the doctors say. But we're optimistic that everything's going to be fine and he'll be joining us again soon. So. We'll see.
Okay, talk about your own performance, 17 points tonight against Rotterdam. You were in a good rhythm.
Yeah, I just started to be aggressive early. It got me going, started rebounding. I mean, they're a big team, but I just wanted to be aggressive today. I got 3 more games left in the Plaza, regular season that is, and that was my objective coming in here.
Time flies like an idiot. It's already half March.
Yeah, it does. It's really sinking in. You see the sun start to come out, and you know it's the end of the year. We want to be playing at our best basketball, and we're trying to imply some new things before the playoffs and before the cup game. So it wasn't the game we wanted it to be. It was a little close at the end, but at the same time, we've done some experiences and with the playing times and different players, rotations. So I guess we're trying new things.
Do you know the Franca guy, 31 points, 18 years old?
Yeah, I know. I played against him with him in the All-Star game. He's a good Dutch talent. I mean, he can score. I mean, obviously, everybody knows that. He
head scorer of the league, huh?
Yeah, he's a big-time scorer. And for his team to compete and to be competitive, he needs to score. So we'll see. We'll see what he does. But, the kid can score.
So what now? Sunday's the next game. How do you cope with it as a team with an injury like that?
Well, we don't really want to jump to conclusions yet because we don't know what it is. We're hoping that it's, just a kick to the back of the leg and everything was fine. But right now we have to wait till tomorrow to see what it is, and then from there we have to regroup. We'll have Thomas back. We missed Thomas tonight with the rebounding and his big body, but I mean that's basketball. Things happen, but we're gonna pray and hope that everything is okay with DeJuan. Thank you.
Well, Clark, we won against Rotterdam, but shit happens with injuries and things like that. And you had 5 fouls. What's your impression of the game?
I mean, I feel like I've been struggling the last couple games so far as defense. I mean, I don't know what it is. I don't know if I'm over-aggressive. I don't know if I'm too tough, but I mean, a lot of times I feel like I'm just getting singled out on getting fouls. So it's been very difficult getting the rhythm of my game. And
you got to get used to the referees maybe in Holland?
I don't know what it is, you know, but I mean, anyone that's smart, that knows basketball watching the game can see that I'm really getting singled out with the fouls, you know, and it's disappointing, but, you know, I got to work through it. And, I mean, it's another victory in the book, so, you know, we just got to keep pushing to get better in practice and each game.
The positive things. Now you're a couple of weeks here in Groningen. How are you doing? Do you like it?
Yeah, I'm fine. The weather is getting better, so I'm
enjoying. We're happy with that.
Yeah. You know, I'm enjoying that, and, you know, seeing the city more and more each day. You know, any downtime, any free time that I have, like, you know, I try to go see the city and just enjoy myself. You know, that's pretty much it.
Talking about Groningen, next week we got elections. We saw a video on the internet. You promoted some guy. Do you know anything about Dutch elections? Elections?
No, I have no idea. Just a little bit that he told me about. You know, and you know, I just met him not too long ago. So anything I could do to help, you know, I can help. You know.
Do you know which party you promoted?
PVDA.
Well, it's good you remember that.
Remember that? Yeah. So I don't know too much about it, but I mean, hopefully,
like a favorite.
Yeah, hopefully, you know, something happens. And, I mean, he's young, so the idea that he's even on the ballot, I think, is a blessing, you know, because I mean, I'm sure a lot of people are, you know, trying to, you know, get into the elections, you know, to do something to help the Groningen community, which is appreciated, I'm sure, by all the people. But, I mean, there's only one winner. So.
And about your defensive style and your fouls, keep the good vibration. It will work out.
Man, I hope so. You know, I'm getting down and down, you know, more each game, and just the frustration is starting to take over.
You shouldn't do that.
I mean, it's difficult, you know, in my position, you know, just coming to a team, you know, for, you know, not even 2 months, and, you know, taking, what, 6-7 games to get adjusted, you know, it's difficult, you know, so I'm trying, you know, but it's hard, you know, it's my first time to this league.
The audience likes your style, think about that.
Yeah, and I enjoy the audience. You know, they can see that I'm emotional, that, you know, I'm a fighter, and, I, you know, I really enjoy the game, and, you know, and I will do anything for my team to win. You know, I don't know.
Keep it up, Bill.
I'm trying, man. Thank you.